Hey, this is Amy, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the entrance exams that you would need for admission to graduate school. So first of all, you need to know what test is right for you. So it would depend on the type of school that you are applying to. For business school, the GMAT, which is Graduate Management Admissions Test, is most commonly required. A lot of different disciplines use the general GRE test. That stands for Graduate Record Examination, and some schools do actually ask you to take subject GREs. The LSAT, Law School Admissions Test, is for law school. The Medical College Admissions Test is MCAT for medical school. There's like the DAT, which is Dental Admissions Test. Pharmacy would be PCAT, Pharmacy College Admissions Test. So there's lots of different types of tests depending on the program that you're going to go into. And then if you are not a native English speaker, a lot of times programs ask that you take an English proficiency test as well. So it really does depend on the program and school that you're going to and what they require. So the best way to find out that information is to check the admissions requirements. And another reason that this is an important thing to do is because a lot of schools are actually moving away from requiring admissions tests or test scores for admission to programs. So just be aware of that. These tests can cost hundreds of dollars. So rather than paying for a test you end up not needing, be sure that you are just double checking. And it would be bad if you, you know, took a test and then end up not needing that test. So anyway. The first test to talk about is the GMAT, and you can find information about it at mba.com. It does cost $250, and it takes 210 minutes. The scores are valid for 5 years, so if you are applying to a program and it's been longer than 5 years since you've taken the test, you would have to retake it. And on the right-hand side of the screen, this shows the closest testing centers that offers this test in the Dalton area. So we have one in Chattanooga, one is in Dahlonega, and then we have a few in Atlanta, and then Knoxville. So each test is going to be offered at a different testing center, and the websites with information about the test would give you that listing of centers, and you can select dates and see when things are available, and you would schedule your test. The GRE, I have a map here showing the GRE testing centers that are closest to us here in Dalton. Again, there's one in Chattanooga, and then the remainder are a little further away. GRE is run by a company called ETS. I think that stands for Educational Testing Service. So you would just go to ets.org/GRE. It does cost $205, and it takes 225 minutes to take the exam. Scores are again valid for 5 years. And that's the general GRE. There are subject GREs, and that would likely be offered at the same testing centers. It would just be a separate test, a separate charge. So just be aware of that. LSAT, the Law School Admissions Test. If you go to lsac.org/JD/LSAT, you can find more information about this particular test, but I actually just posted these logos of different schools in our area that offer that test. So it costs $190, it takes 210 minutes, and similar to the rest of the tests we've covered so far, scores are again valid for 5 years. The MCAT has a complicated URL, but basically if you just Google MCAT information, you'll probably be able to find it's AAMC is the website, AAMC.org. So if you can get to that website, you'll be able to find the MCAT information. Of course, you can go straight to this link as well, and I will post that. I'll post all the links in the comments. But anyway, the MCAT is the most costly of all the tests that we've talked about so far. It does cost $315. It takes 450 minutes to take the test, and scores are valid for 5 years. Again, it's offered at different testing locations within driving distance from the Dalton area, and you can use the locator if you want to look at a particular other area as well. Okay, and there are other specialized exams. I did already talk about the assessments of English skills, and that would just depend on the school and the program to which you're applying. And then there is also the MAT. Some education programs will allow you to take the MAT rather than the GRE, and it does tend to be a little bit more inexpensive. MAT stands for Miller Analogies Test, and it's basically just like all analogies. So the DAT is Dental College, PCAT, Pharmacy College. So just depending on what program you're trying to get into, the exam would be dependent on that. But again, a lot of places are not requiring these exams quite as much for admission. And be sure that you know you're matching up what where you're trying to go with what they are requiring for admission. So yeah, if you need help finding information about graduate school application and exams and everything like that, if you have questions or you know, you're interested in finding test prep materials, just get in touch with the library. We're happy to help. So hopefully this is useful information to you, and best of luck with your future endeavors, including any applications to graduate school.